I work here for Mr. Rogers as an associate in the risk assessment and management office at MBS.
What is the nature of the problem?
Okay, well, as you probably know, over the last 36 to 40 months, the firm has begun packaging new MBS products that combine several different tranches of rating classification in one tradable security. This has been enormously profitable. Now, the problem, which is, I guess, why we are here tonight, is that it takes us, the firm, about a month to layer these products correctly, thereby posing a challenge from a risk management standpoint.
And, Mr. Sullivan, that challenge is?
Well, we have to hold these assets on our books longer than we might ideally like to.
Yes.
But the key factor here is these are essentially just mortgages, so that has allowed us to push the leverage considerably beyond what you might be willing or allowed to do in any other circumstance, thereby pushing the risk profile without raising any red flags.
Considering the, shall we say, bumpy road we've been on the last week or so, that the figures your brilliant co-workers up the line ahead of you have come up with don't make much sense anymore, considering what's taking place today.
Actually, not what's taking place today, but what's already taken place over the last 2 weeks.
So you are saying this has already happened?
If those assets decrease by just 25% and remain on our books, that loss would be greater than the current market capitalization of this entire company.
What can we do about it? What have I told you since the first day you stepped into my office? There are three ways to make a living in this business. Be first, be smarter, or cheat. Now, I don't cheat.
No, I don't cheat.
No, I don't cheat. No, I don't cheat. I don't cheat. And although I like to think we have some pretty smart people in this building,
it sure is a hell of a lot easier to just be first.
Sell it all today.
Is that even possible, Sam?
Yes.
If I made you, how would you do this?
Well, you call the traders in for the normal 6:30 meeting and you be honest with them, because they're going to know it's the end either way. So you're going to have to throw them a bone, and a pretty big one. And then you've got to come out of the gate storming. No swaps, no nothing. 40% done by 10:15. By 11 o'clock, all your trades have to be gone, because by lunchtime, word's going to be out. And by 2 o'clock, you're going to be selling at 65 cents on the dollar, if you're lucky. And then the feds are going to be in here, up your ass, trying to slow you down.
Ramek.
Can slow you down. They can't stop you. It's yours to sell.
Yeah, but, John, even if we manage to pull that off, and that's saying something. The question is, who are we selling this to?
Same people we've been selling it to for the last 2 years, and whoever else will buy.
But John, if you do this, you will kill the market for years. It's over. And you're selling something that you know has no value.
We are selling to willing buyers at the current fair market price, so that we may survive.
You will never sell anything to any of those people ever again.
I understand.
Do you?
Do you? This is it. I'm telling you, this is it.